right, guys, here we go. It is officially day one, week four. It's the start of week four, which that makes it day 21. You can see how lovely everybody's doing. The BleedGold. Of course, our Walter, you can see she's having her issues. She could be using a little bit more cow mag, which is a little ironic because when we were setting up this light, even on their grow tips, they recommend using these lights that you may add more calcium and magnesium than normally needed. And I'm not gonna lie, that actually seems to be the case with the Walters. So maybe it has something to do with the light and the low heat of the light, or affecting the mobility of the calcium magnesium. Over here on the Pinkman side, they're killing it. Remember, it's not a true side-by-side because we're not doing the same strains. We're not really comparing. But this run, the Pinkman is looking very, very, very nice. Give her about 2 more weeks, and if she's gonna goo, she will goo. She doesn't always goo, guys, but if she's gonna goo, it'll be in about a week or two. But you can definitely see, tell her apart, the way that she chunks up early. She gives us thick white hairs. Over here, we got some of our golden oldie, kind of spiritually sitting over on the side. But again, we're in flower, so like I've been saying, there's nothing to do. I'm literally not doing anything. I haven't been in here for a few days. This is my first time in here, and I'm going to leave in probably a few minutes. Actually, I'll probably smoke a blunt with the girls. I like smoking blunts with the girls. Hey, just me and my bitches, huh? What do you know? So if you haven't seen the first video, the unboxing and setting up Mars Hydro, our Govee, so make sure you check that out. I'm not sure if I also showed you the little mother tent that we started building to put our small genetics in. But for the most part, guys, go green, grow purple. There we go. So we stripped them down. Got rid of most of the remaining families that were in there. See, they're basically starting to stand up nice now. Going on to week five here, so they're just gonna put it under mass bulk and with flour. Walk the white right here. Let's see, this is the bleed hole. Out the Pinkman right now that we haven't gone over here. So this is how it's been. We're gonna thin her out, get rid of some of the other leaves that are done doing their job. So you see this, we're not gonna want to thin too much more than that. Maybe we will. Now, if I end up doing more, I'll show you guys. So you can see how that looks from going before to after. So, I will say, a little smaller development at this stage than I would like. Really nice back there. I would expect it to look more like but as you know from the Pinkman, sometimes she goes like this and sometimes she goes like this. The Walter is very finicky, but the BleedGold is not. So that's what's surprising, is that BleedGold usually never does this. I can't say that it is the light. We do have two BleedGolds over here. Two BleedGolds over here. So once I thin these two out, we'll see if they're experiencing some of the same sparsity as these are. And again, we're just getting into the mid bloom right now, so we should see a pickup come on. But yeah, we'll go from there. There we are. Everybody's thinned out. You can see the Pinkman.
of leaves him in the back.
Guys, and here we are. We are officially on day one, week five, bloom. See how everybody's doing on our Mars Hydro side. So we got all of our BleedGold TankWreck right here. Some of our Walter White, a few more BleedGold, Pinkman, and then Golden. But let's take a little look at some of these flowers. I'll turn this fan off for you guys. I will note that they are growing a little sparse. I'm not sure exactly what to attribute to it. The res and everything else is on point. One thing I might say is that it has been pretty cold here. So even right now it's 64 degrees and the lights are on. So when the lights get off, it's been getting a little breezy and I can see with this fan here. So I'm about to check our readings right here. So let's pop those in there actually right now. Okay, so we're gonna be able to see the temperatures. Now, the reason why I'm thinking it might be the cold is because you can see a little like the iron that might be efficient in some of those, and even the cow mat, but a lot of these have trouble transporting in the cold temperatures because they're mobile nutrients, so the colder it is, the less mobile they're gonna be through the plants. Over here, you have the Pinkman, and they are all looking beautiful. You can almost see that instant ripening with the bud XL. Over here you can see the golden oldies. Now remember the golden oldies, they didn't really get it as high as I'd like them.
Here, look at this little guy over here. Can I help you?
They got towered over, of course, by the Pinkman. The Pinkman's a light whore, and she steals the shine from everybody. What else we got more back over here? All under one, LEC, 315 watt. So all these are really gonna start picking up over the next week or two. Nice and cleaned up below. Went in here and stripped everything yesterday, if you remember.
Hey, how could you not remember? You were just watching the video, huh?
And now is close to the real, true set it and forget it time. So it's really just about making sure that certain branches don't stand up and overpower other branches. And if you remember from the beginning video, this is about where we said they would be. So considering in this tent, we got about 280 and 315, that's like barely 600 watts. I guarantee there's not a 600 watt bulb pushing out this right here. So, actually, we did this on a mover, but still, this is a lot more thicker than what's on mover. Like even this one, right in the dead center, she's one of the thicker nugs because she's getting the double light penetration, but she's also getting the least amount of direct light. And we have some of the nickels in the back that are really nice. No goop yet. There's no goo yet.
But everybody's looking beautiful.
Life. Not much to do. Getting the res, we're at 6.0, 640, 69. That's not bad considering we started it at
1650, so they've only went up, you know, 40 overnight, one feeding.
Your side is gone.
Overstrip the Walter, if you remember, because she's very finicky. So if you overstrip her, she won't plump. So that's pretty much what we're doing right now. We're in plump zone. That's it, guys. We'll be back in a week. Morning, America, and we are back. It's actually day five, week five bloom, so it's been about four or five days, and I just wanted to come and take a peek at the girls. You can see a good thing we did, because the nutrients have jumped up, at least in the left res, to 2110, which isn't like the most horriblest thing, because, you know, they can take a decent amount, but let's give them a little assessment. I don't see any major burning or anything. You can see a slight tip burn on some of these leaves right here. So that's one of the tall tale signs that you're gonna wanna draw back the nutrients. Again, we just added the top booster as well. So that's what happens when you add that mid-bloom additive, is that it really drains all of the nutrients out of the plant as it's giving it nutrients that makes it feel like, hey, it's ending its cycle. So that's a standard thing. Here we have under the 315 watt LEC. And over here, the 280 watt, 2000 rated LED. What I say, remember, this isn't a true side by side because genetics grow differently, so you can't just look at this and look at that and say, oh, no. But what you can do is just look at these and say, hey, are you growing or are you not growing? Would you do good if you had a full room? Or would you not? Watching this fan. Now, I was hoping the Walters would bulk up a little bit more. Now, she's not bulking how she normally does. But again, I can't say that that's directly related to the light per se. But sometimes she does that, and to be honest, cutting it right here, she's getting a good half of the lights. It's not like, the light's not giving her enough. I don't know, they're growing, it's weird. The way that they're growing, I would normally raise my light. Except not, just knowing how low water she is. It's not like they're hot, but sometimes you can have a light toxicity, even though it's not hot. The lumens don't show that it's light toxicity, but the plants are showing just the slightest signs of stress. And you can see the ones in the back are actually very, very plump. You can see all that crystal that's caked on all those leaves right there. They're doing really nice. And they're a little bit further away from the light. But again, that's why we like to review the products first. This is our first review, per se. And then after the fact, we're gonna take a bunch of cuttings. Comment below, let me know which cuttings you guys would like to see a full room of. It's kind of hard because a lot of times we have mixed genetics, so we kind of have to keep circulating. But in the future, if you would like to see one more predominant strain grow, whether it's the Pinkman, whether it's the BleedGold or the Walter White, let me know, and I will keep that in mind for the next full side-by-side. Look how beautiful she is right there. usually a lot more crisplier. She hasn't been doing very well lately, but I think that's because I haven't really been giving her any real light. I literally just like, hey, over here. So yeah, maybe this next run, we'll do a whole run of the Goldie. There we go. There you go, guys. That's all we're doing for today. If you notice, well, you don't notice because I didn't tell you, but
we didn't do anything. All we did was add the top booster. So at the end of the rundown, I'm actually going to give you guys from a start to a finish of the nutrients. I don't know if I'm going to post the nutrients, but I'm at least going to give you a water breakdown because I have a new technique to where I don't change the resin every week like a lot of people do. Sometimes I go 2 weeks. For instance, when you're looking at the feed, and I'm using the House and Garden because I was using their base, and I'm using always user. I always use something from House and Garden, and I just like the way they lay out their feed schedule. But if you notice, it's literally all the same products. All the same products. All you're doing is tapering off the nitrogen additives. That's it. Increasing your mains just ever so slightly, which I don't do. And then you're adding your buttock cell, your top booster, and then your shooting powder. So those are the three tiers down. So for the most part, I try to keep this the same res. I'll make a res here for veg, for veg. Sometimes I even let the veg one go into the week two flower, or if I change it here, I'll let this res go easily to here, and then I'll change it before I add this. And then sometimes I'll change it before this. Like this time we did not change it from the step down because we changed it here. So we made a fresh batch right here and they went through this whole week. And I honestly don't think that they took all of the nutrients in that 1 week just from that feeding. So I just added the top booster to the buttock cell run like they should here. And then next week on week six, we're gonna do a fresh batch and run that out. So if you actually calculate, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 weeks that we saved. So if you had 5 weeks of water, that's a decent savings. And you can see it's, you know, I'm not doing a horrible buildup of any kind of salt or, hey, we do have really high right there. And remember guys, we actually run the 700 scale. So a lot of people, their PPMs aren't in the 700 units, they'll use like the TDS 500. So technically that would, you know, depending on who's looking at it, that would just be a 1500, or depending on what meter you're using, always use the high just because it gives me a little added buffer if needed. I'm gonna make this video short because this whole series has been very long. Okay, mate, that's it. You guys go smoke one if you haven't already burnt one. Call it a day, or morning, or whatever time it is where you're at. Ready for this? Yo, because we elevate in the mind state, defining high stakes, your state to my state, motivational hydrate, minute to minute, definitively in it, hit it and find faith, educating the great growers coast to coast to tie and break, manipulation of mother nature to proper flavor, topical creams to bomb trees with no danger. Oh, there we go. Changing the res right now, guys. We're officially on day one. Week six bloom. So it's day 36, week six. These guys have been in the flower for 36 days. Some of that bleed gold. Some more of the bleed gold. Got the wolf of white. And then of course the show stealer is always the Pinkman. Oh man, look at all the pink. She's beautiful, always. Oh yeah. So we're gonna be gone for about a week for Christmas. Hey, the res is full, about to shut this off. So that's pretty much what we were gonna do. Let's change the res, show you guys what they look like now, and then we will be back in 1 week. So just focus on that view right now. back, right? Now.
Oh man, we are back from our trip.
It has officially been 7 days. So we were actually, what day would that make us? That would put us on day 5, week 6.
So we're like at day 40, day 41. And everybody's looking good. I actually think that the last video I took for you guys, I don't think I pressed record. So there might be a gap between the last video and this one. So let me know. But you see, we got the wall to white. Looking oh so lovely. Looking beautiful. Just under our Mars Hydro.
Here we have,
I'm gonna turn this fan off. Some of that BleedGold, who is not quite bleeding at this moment.
She usually does around this time. It's not a for sure thing, she might not actually bleed. She's looking great. Midweek six,
hardly any contact whatsoever. Looking nice and clean down here. Ah, that's how we can tell. I set up the bug strips in the last video. Let's see if that one filmed. I feel like I filmed it and I just pressed unfilm.
Cool. So hope everybody had a great Christmas, great holiday season, whatever it is you believe in. Hey, look at all this pink. What do you know about the pink? The pink. That's a lot of pink. I love it. Beautiful. Oh yeah, yeah. Beautiful. I love it. So you can see the pink man. He's doing great. I don't see any goose eggs on here either. See a lot of awesomeness. Great. So that's about it, guys.
Again, like I said, there's not much to do.
Come in here and you're like, ooh. You haven't been here for a whole week. 7 complete days. I've not seen them, so the res look light. Res is half full. 1850, 5.7. Where are they at when you left? 1426, so yeah, they definitely went up, which is standard. So actually what I would do, let's see. Since we're using our house and garden as our base calendar, we're in mid six right here. We just added our first dose of shooting powder and we're about to go into the next week. As you can see, nothing changes. Nothing changes. Add a little bit more shooting powder, that's it. So I'm not going to take away all the water. I'm just gonna top it off. So at the end of the cycle, we've probably saved a couple hundred gallons worth of water. So imagine doing that on a large scale, just saving so much. Oh, look at that. Look at those crystals. Beautiful. If you guys ever have any questions, make sure you ask me. I've just been doing this for so long, I just come in here and ramble. I don't have any real structure to these videos. I'm like, there's a little bit of structure, but I just wing it. Just because that's the most awesome thing you can do, is just wing it. It's So
any questions you guys want to ask me, I'm here. There's no CO2 in here. It's literally just passive exhaust. Passive intake comes from there. Underneath here, there's a couple open ports. Showing you the feed setup a couple times. That's it, guys. Not much to see here. Day 43, and as you can see, everybody is doing great. Not much to do right now. As you know, I've been telling you what we've been doing is not changing the res, but really just topping off with water during key times. Now keep in mind, having mixed strains, you're gonna see certain deficiencies from time to time because they're all being fed off the same res. So not much we can do right now. They're at 19. So we're just gonna top it off with water and see where that takes us. Pinkman, oh man. Hey, you messed my sweatshirt, what do you know? Beautiful. Talk so they don't shake. Should be beautiful all the way through. I love the pink man. And again, guys, it's not a real side by side because we're doing different strains on both sides. So, actually, comment below, let me know what genetics you think we should run if we're going to do an actual side by side. It took them a minute to give me the light, so I had to run with the genetics we had. We took enough to probably do either the full Walter or maybe the Pinkman. I have to check actually. And we have enough time to take more clones. So by the time, well, I guess it's my, up to me. If I post this to you guys with enough time, I'll get your feedback. Otherwise, no. So I'm gonna make it short, simple. I'm gonna top off each res. That's it. Maybe I'll give you a reading afterwards, okay? Drop it down to about 1620. If you look at what we were running before, so week six, we were, after all of our nutrients, we were about 1420. At the end, the start of week 30, week four, 1600. So remember, we were just topping it off with water this entire time until we got to about here. But we were at, on week seven, or day seven, which was about week four, we were at 18. So we fed at 16. So fed at 16, carry over the 1420 is what we fed week six. Now we're gonna feed back again to around 1620. So we're keeping the nutrients semi within the same range, especially since we're just topping off with water for the most part and a few additives. Other than that, we're keeping everything pretty neutral. Pretty neutral there for you. Look at some of these Walters. Now, they did peak a little. Like I was saying, they were at 19, but we were gone for over a week. Not much we can do about that. We should have been topping them off with water as they fed, keeping them around the same strength, which is what we're gonna do while we're here. But while we're gone, and it is what it is. Alrighty. notice how healthy she is and how apparently, not stressed, but the water always does her thing. And they notice how healthy the pinkmen are. So again, it's just a genetics thing, feeding multiple strains on the same feed system.
Ooh. And here we go, guys. It is officially day 7, week 7 of bloom. And here we are. We're actually gonna be changing the res tomorrow. So what I wanted to do is come in here and do the very last stripping. As you can see, like, some of these bigger colas, you can't really see through it. So you can't even really see the colas because of all the excess leaf in there. So what we're gonna do is strip off that final layer and then top off these reses again. Maybe add a sugar additive, see if we have any terpenator or something else just to help plump them up. But yeah, everybody's looking great.
The Walter White.
Hey, the circle under the Walter Purple, huh?
Oh, the sand has gotta be annoying. Hold on. Boom. The BleedGold. This is actually my first time in here since the last video, so I actually haven't looked for any globs. We'll see. As I'm stripping off this leaf, I'll take a look to see if we have any goo sites this run. There may or may not be. She's actually gooed every single run for about the last 8 years. So if she doesn't have it somewhere, I would be surprised. I do the same thing over and over again. That's the bleed. Over here. Hey, do I even gotta tell you who this is? Can't you see? Oh man. She's beautiful. Of course, it's the Pinkman. But she's solo, I don't see any goo on her either. She actually hasn't gooed for a while, guys, but she was the one that started it all. It's because when I was, you know, initially growing, this is a golden oldie. She's not doing so well. Her strain's been put on the back burner. And again, that's what's hard, because the Pinkman, she finishes earlier than some of the other strains. So it is a little tricky running multiple genetics under the same feeding sometimes. But look at that color, it's beautiful. And you can see they're, you know, they're starting to yellow, which is kind of good. We've just been using water. Remember, we've just been topping it off with water. So some of them are semi-starving for nutrients, but we don't want the nutrients, and that's why we don't want our nugs to sizzle, to pop. We want some nice, clean, white ash. And that's one of the ways I accomplish that, by tapering off my nutrients early. During the flower stage, I'm not going as much by what the leaves. Oh my Lord, that is a beautiful shot right there. On what the leaves want as much as I'm going by what the buds want. Oh, my pinky. Hey, yeah. Same color. Actually, really like that. What do you know? So, yeah, I'm gonna thin this out a little bit. Thin this out a little bit. And look for some goo. Find a nice shiny nug. Remember, guys, 280 watts, 315. This is all 600 watts, roughly. That's a phenomenal amount of.
Hey, guys, I just love her so much.
Amount of flour for 600 watts. Okay, man. Boom, boom, boom. And here we are, day 1, week 9 of bloom, guys. all this underneath our Mars Hydro 280 watt TS2000. And then we have our Sun Systems 315 watt LEC over there. You can see they're doing really great, you know, considering. Good structure, good size. You know, these are good 8-inch colas, 10-inch colas. And in there you can see the quality. Actually very nice. BleedGold TankWreck. And then the backs look beautiful. Since last week's really gonna be pretty much just pumping up. As you see, we've been topping off the res, and even right now we're at 1940. Top this back off. We're gonna end up flushing half of it, or draining half of it, topping off with water, and then just continuing that drain. Just to pretty much signify again that we're on flush. We don't want to have any residual products left over here, heavy metals or any of that that are prevalent in the nutrients. Even little side nugs are looking beautiful. Head over here to the Pinkman. Oh, hey, ain't no Photoshop there, huh? So she's really pinking up like she always does. Always so pink towards the end. Beautiful. 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 All the way through. Looking lovely. Every single nug. So just last week of flush, what we are going to do. You can see about a week ago when we were in here, we took off most of the leaves, so there's not really too much more that needs to be removed. Everybody's looking good. You can see you still have really good penetration through the canopy. So that's what's important, to make sure that when you're growing, hey, I pressed the off button, that you still have some much needed light penetration all the way through the canopy. So you can see, you still see the light. So that means it's not too congested. Let's do a side view. Not bad for less than 600 watts. Not bad at all. So what do you guys think? What's your standard 600 watt yield? Huh? I think the most that we've gotten is probably maybe like, let's say about almost 2.25. But we were maxing out space too. They're actually 600s with dimmable ballasts, so they would actually go up to like a 720, but we were filling up a whole 5x5 space. So just on this though, that's 600 watts. Most 600 watt bulbs can't get you this much flower. So we're actually gonna see what the yield is when we're done. There's no need for us to bag and tag each plant when we harvest, because we're not doing a side by side. What we will do though is we are gonna do a light versus light. And again, those aren't going to be straight comparisons, because the Bleed Gold and the Walter are way more denser than the Pinkman. So it's just going to be more so for our notes. And then the next run, we're going to do even plants on even sides. So we'll probably still do mixed genetics, because we like to have multiple strains to smoke. But we're going to probably do, as you can see, we have 4, 8, 12, 16. So we'll do maybe 4 of each. That's it. Okay, we'll be back.
Yo, Dop Dock here. We got them laying down our frame cage. We got our 818 headband over here. We got our Skywalker OG over here. And similar on the sides, on the sides, on the sides. All kind of angles, green, go purple. Stay tuned, subscribe. YouTube.com/CalicRapDoc. All kind of angles.
Boom, boom. So as you can see, we've started chopping down. Got through maybe two plants close to that. I'm gonna give you guys a little zoom zoom of what's going on here. It's looking beautiful. Oh man, all the way through. That fuchsia, which the Pinkman is known for. It's beautiful. So usually what we would do is hang all these on a rack and oh man, we'd hang them on a rack and let them hang dry with their stems for a little bit. But since we're about to transplant right after, we're just going to pop them in here. We're going to stick them on a dry rack and let them hang. And then we're going to chop the lead gold in the next couple days. Again, I just wanted to you guys a little scoop on what we got going. Oh man. Pinkman.
see as I'm chopping her down. See how beautiful she looks. The reds, the fuchsias, the purple. BleedGold left.
Boom. As you can see, Pinkman's gone. So we chopped her. She was down on about day 63. So I'm sure you just got done watching that. I don't even know why I need to tell you. So this is the BleedGold. And she's about ready to come down here soon too. We're flushing her. Turn off this fan. We're flushing her. I just turned off the camera. So we're flushing her right now. And as you can see, she got a few little branches with some goop loop. What's she doing? She does. And then I think I noticed it on another branch. Oh yeah, right over here. So that means that she's probably gonna be good on some other branches. Right here we have the Walter White. Remember, this is all under the Mars Hydro, so that's another reason why I wanted to harvest all minus these three, so I lied to you. The tank wreck can actually go a little bit longer. If you remember, the amazing thing about the Pinkman is that she grows with the size of a sativa and the flavor of a sativa, but she actually has indica dominant parents, so she finishes early like indica. She's actually kind of a weird strain, so we are actually going to get her pheno, her geno checked. I know that there's a few companies out there like Phylos or etc. that can actually check the genetic markers, so that'll be interesting. But minus this, which I will cover with my hand, this is all what was done under the Mars Hydro. So pretty impressive. Remember, it's only 280 watts. And I can see the goo. See the goo, she shimmers when the light hits her. So just now I noticed there's some goo. First time seeing it myself. So she starts doing that once she starts ripening. We're on day 64 right now. So that's when she's just really peaking up. And we've been flushing them yesterday. Once I chopped them down, I went ahead and drained the res and fed them this morning. So they were at 1600, and then we put it in with a 500 of just base water and Clear-X, and they're at 850. But that's still a 300 ppm raise. I like to flush until we have about 150 ppm raise, just to make sure that there's nothing in there, especially when you're using hydro. So we're gonna flush them again and give them a couple more days. You can see that the colors are really coming on. Which signifies that they're about ripe. Especially with the Walter, she only purples up towards the very, very end. If she's going to, and then all these other leaves start yellowing and dying off. Which is what happens when you're flushing. I'll put some better pictures. I don't know why this shit's so blurry right now. Oh, I was touching the lens. Even down towards the bottom, it's got nice structure. So we're gonna chop these girls down here in a couple days. Right now, again, it's like a simmer, just flushing. So we get some more shots for you. Guys, it's just once a week maintenance. We're not doing much, but the plants just have an optimal environment to do what they want to do. it.
Freeze up popsicles, sugar the gold, the rose. Not the only one with obstacles. Molecules made emotion, emotion is diabolical. Moderately speaking, even the vegan sees it's hard to grow. Farms are only greener when the meter's already got money. Got tummies that need to be fed, so I said that I'm not hungry. Got something to say, then say it before the clock's buzzing. And wakes you up realizing life's been a lot of nothing. A lot of looking, no cooking, a whole lot of hunting. A lot of ducking around the corner from the morning bully. And as you get older, the bullies never really go away. You just gotta choose who your friends with. Appreciate before depreciation rates you as a lost cause. Knockoffs from overseas thinking you're the condon. Creme de la creme, yeah, but in the wrong sauce. High in sodium, no taste, so kick rocks.
Here we go again, yes, it keeps spinning. Here we go again, life it keeps spinning. Here we go again, yes, it keeps spinning.
Spinning, never stopping, always spinning.
Here we go again.
The merry-go-round bound to keep spinning. When the spinning stops, high as a rooftop. Two tops and nightgowns, all I wear are crew socks. Boombox provides the vibe, I vibe as you rock. From sandy beaches to the pebbles outside your spot. Soft as silk spun straight from the web. Ebenezer on his leisure time, diamonds, fresh bread. Best press a couple pounds of blood into my head. Do the Fred, yabba dabba doo, hand you the rest. Lazy lions get no meat and eat less. At least what's left, no stress, come recess. Fresh at a fresh farms, organically grown west. New recipe, come armed if you wanna come threat. Young Depp, Johnny at his finest, you have. Two-step progression, U.S. roulette. None back, never unless it gets you wet. If you step on it, don't stop, you bet.
Here we go again.
Boom, and here we are, guys. It is officially day 64, and we're chopping everybody down. As you can see, you already know, we were just in here, we chopped down the Pinkman. We fed them, they're at 870, so we're gonna drain the res one more time. We're gonna fill it with fresh water because they raised about 300. I like to keep the plants at 150 ppm swing, which means when it's time to flush, whatever you put the water in. So I'm gonna be using tap water. Our tap water is anywhere from 350 to 470. So after we feed them from 350 to 470, I don't want the PPMs to raise more than 150. Oh, hold on, let me turn this pump around. It's not gonna drain. There we go. So I'm gonna stop taking the video in a second because the water's gonna come. I just wanna show you guys how beautiful everybody's looking, of course. Got our goo right here, looking amazing. That BleedGold TankWreck. She got beautiful structure all the way up. Just look at that crystal, looking lovely in her 280 watt bulb. Got another nice nug right here. She too has the goo. You can see it right now. You can point it out. All these flowers are looking beautiful. Now Walter, she's looking great. I love how she purpled up. A lot of the times she doesn't really purple up. It's really difficult because when you're growing multiple strains, it's really hard to decide who to cater to. It's like if you got one fat kid and one skinny kid, it's like, do you keep feeding them so that the one fat kid gets fatter and fatter just so the skinny kid can bulk up? Or do you underfeed them so that the fat kid gets skinnier, but then the skinny kid's gonna starve to death? So, hey, you like that analogy, huh? So that's pretty much what's going on here with the plants. It's like some plants wanna eat more than others, and it's kinda like, who do you cater to? In certain scenarios, a lot of the times I end up catering towards the BleedGold just because she's got the goo, and I like the goo. But then everybody else suffers. It's gonna start getting really annoying. I gotta stop this, I'll be back.
Hey, you got that true gold. That bleed gold tank wreck. See the goo? And she's got it on the other side as well.
Boom. So we just put the water in, it's 420, 7.6. pH doesn't matter because we're not having them pick up any nutrients, but you can see, so now it's 430. So as we feed, it's just gonna keep flushing, 440. So as long as this doesn't go above 570, I would like it to be below 570 when I harvest. And that's just me. A lot of people are like, oh, as long as you're below 300 of a swing. And I'm like, no, that's you, as long as you're below 300 of a swing. I like to keep my swing just a little bit different. And as I was sitting here, hey, look at the little goo. There's goo everywhere. And the fun thing is, you can see, I found goo on this plant right here. So just knowing that there is goo on this branch, where does this branch go? Hey, it goes to this plant. I guarantee you there's goo on the big cola of that plant. And the more and more you look, if you look just right, you will see there's a good glob there. There was another one up here somewhere. I noticed the glob right there. Oh, there it is, right up top. Boom, right in the center. In the light, so see that right there in the center? Hey, it's like an Easter egg hunt. Looking for the goo, huh? So that's always fun. Beautiful. Bleed gold tank wreck. These last couple runs, she's been purpling up really nice. Looks beautiful. Again though, I can't wait to smoke this Walter. You can just see the crystal concentration. Everybody's so beautiful. All under 280. So much crystal this blunt. Hey, what am I smoking on? What do you know? There was some goo in it. Hey, there it is right there. Want to smoke some goo? Come into my garden. And I will smoke you out with some goo. Oh, there's some more. Goo in the blunt.
And the blunt's rolled. We got the backwood going. And they're still flushing. 560.
Sorry about that, guys. Battery died, I had to charge it up, but we're just about done. It's been about 30 minutes. You see we're at 570 and 74, man, that doesn't matter. So we started at 420, so that's about 150. So this is a very good range to show you that there has been very little, and we let the blocks dry out overnight. We did this last night and we let them dry out again. Only having that one feed, so this goes to show you that there was very little residuals left after our first couple flushes. So that's not it. It's not time to chop just yet. So the main thing, guys, is don't rush it. When you get to this stage, last thing you want to do is rush it and waste all that precious work that you've been putting in. So what I recommend doing now is we're going to turn off our lights, even though the lights are supposed to be on. We're going to turn off the lights for, you know, a good 24 hours and let them really just ripen. All the crystals, all the trichomes are going to come towards the end, towards the tips at night. And a lot of the terpene production and a lot of production happens more so at nighttime. So we're going to give them one last night to really push all that out. And then we will chop these girls in the morning. And of course, we're gonna go goo hunting first. So I'll let you know if I see any more goo than just a couple of globs that we found. So far, I think we have 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 globs that we know of, but just a bunch of branches from each of those plants. Can't even see those back there, so who knows what's going on back yonder. All right, guys, see you in the morning. Boom. And now it's time for chopping, guys. You see, we have them set overnight. I literally just turned the lights on just so we can get one last look at how much we actually got off this one little light. So now that we have these other plants gone, you can see a nice side view. Some of these back plants. Trellis. Oh. That's the bleed gold. Walter. So we're gonna chop these girls down. I'm gonna get some closer ups, and you can see that some of the goo has even, you know, so you pick it up on the camera right here in the crust of that, there's some goo. And we have some more goo that's getting bigger right here. Since last time, or since last night. There's the other one right here. Oh, and then that's up here as well. So there's some goo in there. And then pour it out onto right here. And I did notice a couple over here in the back. And we saw some earlier. I think it was on one of these nugs. But we'll give you more close-ups as they come. I'm just going to get to chopping these. Beautiful. One more side on the round. Chop city time. I lied, we'll take a couple more pictures. Hey, they're friends. I always say that the Walter looks like a little Koopa shell. Mario. Not the shell, but the little battle tail. Boom, boom, boom. All right, guys, so I'm gonna break down some of these numbers for you real quick, and then I'm gonna go to a better lit area and pull out some of the jars. You can see that we just got everything kind of weighed up for the most part. We did our trimming. We got some of our gubbets right down here on trimmable crap. And then it's pretty much the jars of everything. We have our LED versus our LEC. And it wasn't a verse. Remember, this wasn't this product versus that product because they're different strains. We had the Pinkman and the BleedGold and some Granddaddy OG, which we thought was the Golden Oldie, which wasn't. And then we had some BleedGold and Walter White. So different strains, different numbers of plants, but it was more so just to semi get a realistic view of what's going on with the growing and how the light just worked as if a patient. I remember I didn't do anything special. I wasn't trying to use anything that we know as a grower to make anything better or less than the others. But so as you can see, for the most part, these are just some quick notes. I'll probably put this in a better format for you as well. But all in all, it did really great. The LEC had about a gram, 0.3 per watt, and then the LED actually had 1.4 grams per watt. So in a nutshell, we had 325 grams from the LEC and 397 grams from the LED, which is amazing. It's 280 watts. And again, we weren't doing anything special. So I kind of did some breaking down. We weighed up each product that was done, and then we, you know, grams, how many watts, grams divided by watts, gram per watt, etc. Total weight, you know, 722 grams total. So the whole tent itself was about 1.21 grams per watt in the whole little space, and we had about 1.6 pounds. So 1.6 pounds in less than 600 watts. So that's a very, 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 very good run for setting it and forgetting it. You guys saw the feed. You know, we did a little maintenance here, a little maintenance there, but it wasn't anything special. So we're actually, make sure you check the inserts right now for the next video, because we're actually going to do the same strain on both sides. We're going to mix it up between, I believe, the Pinkman and the Bleed, and we're going to do a few less plants so we can manage them better. And we're actually going to put these growing how we want to grow them and see if we can actually get some more data for you guys. So let me pull out these jars and show you guys some of the flower, and we'll be back.
You get sandwich in the streets, I put the move down. And you never could repeat who's a dude now. Same as it ever been. San Quinn, same as it ever been. Mr. Quinn and Twunks and P. You can lose your career for taunting me. Me.
Boom, boom, boom. As you can see, fuck it.
You come from a different place, and I know you.
Couldn't imagine back in the back of the classroom. Backpack strap broke, flash the bad mood. Mash the cash, just make the money when you can't do it, live it till you're living, ain't bland, add flavor. Till you measure the mass of fantasia. Spit it till you're labeled a back and back break up. Breaks only when you can't tap, tap, tap it like a dancer.
Don't need a track.
Keep music deeply embedded in the soul. No rope to choke yourself with.
With.
Just flow.
Just flow.
The nozzles open, push them pressure.
Hose.
No kinks, unkinkable. Love my twinkle toes. Pose for a minute till the minute turns cold. Gold diggers always win until they get it, then it's sold. And they're never gonna mention where they got it from before. Torn up from the floor up.
Didn't know.
Whatever happened to class? Do the math. The media's pollutions. Institute.
Trash.
Sweet thing.